Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Chris Lee, alongside, as always, with Jeremy Sadowski. And we're here to bring you exciting high school football action. From Cooper Field at Waller Stadium in beautiful Manhattan Beach, California, St. Football 2016. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Chris Lee, alongside, as always, with Jeremy Sadowski, and we're here to bring you exciting high school football action as your Maricosta Mustangs take on the Morningside Monarchs. Of course, Mustangs and Monarchs, old Ocean League combatants here facing off tonight. Morningside comes into this contest, though, not quite the powerhouse they were back in the old days. Morningside comes in with a 1-5 overall record and 0-1 in the Bay League after their opening Bay League loss last week to Redondo Union, losing 59-14. Their offense has been giving up well over 50 points a game, and their offense is only scoring one to maybe two touchdowns a game, so it's definitely been a struggle of a season for the Monarchs. Meantime, Coach Darryl Martin brings them here on the road, hoping to get back to a 1-1 league record, trying to do so against the Mustangs. Coach Don Morrow, Mustangs lead into this contest with a 4-2 overall record and 1-0 in league, and riding a three-game win streak with wins against West, Newport Harbor, and Peninsula. Two of those three wins on the road, so the Mustangs definitely able to win away and at home, but happy to be back here at Waller Stadium tonight. It's a special night here for the Mustangs. Of course, it is homecoming night, so we will have special halftime presentation for you fans revolving around homecoming, but meantime, we got a game to play first. Jeremy, talk to me about the Morningside Monarchs. Of course, again, mentioned an old Ocean League combatant of the Mustangs. Morningside's one win was Centennial, an Ocean League combatant of the Mustangs. So talk to me about Morningside Monarchs and what can we expect from Coach Darryl Martin's team.
Well, Chris, like you mentioned, this Monarch team is definitely an old rival of ours. We came up short in the Ocean League championship game back in 1990 versus these Morningside Monarchs. But like you did mention, they have come on some hard times as of late this season, only having one victory so far. However, they do have a few talented skill position players to keep your eye on. Number one, Patrick June, who you'll see at wide receiver and running back. Number 17, Aaron Turner, will be the quarterback, who is really mobile and can fling the ball all around the field. And also keep an eye out for number four, Tyron Harvey. So this team has some talent. They have some issues with depth. They don't have too many players on the team. However, I know they'll give it a good effort tonight, and this Mustang team better be ready for the Monarchs.
Of course, Coach Ray Lee, defensive coordinator for this Mustang team, is looking at one of his better defensive squads here. Certainly in recent memory, Mustangs in those last three wins have given up 7 points to West, who traditionally has a very high-scoring offense. Blanked Newport Harbor, shut them out completely, and then only gave up 7 points at Peninsula in a day game, which Mustangs have struggled with in the past. So this defense has really shown up. Two shutouts this season, the other one, of course, being against Torrance in the Mustang season opener. So Mustangs D has looked sharp all year long. Right in the middle of that, of course, is big number 41, Jonah Tavaier, the lineman, really starts that defense off by creating a lot of havoc right up the middle. But he's not the only one who's really performed well this year on defense. Jeremy, talk to me about that Mustangs D, and maybe give me another player or two who's really impressed you.
Chris, you mentioned Jonah Tavai. Don't forget the linebacker Cody Kellenbach. You have Jordan Fisher, who is not going to be suiting up tonight. He's been extremely well in the linebacker spot. You have, don't forget, Blake Snyder. You have Sam Blake. You'll have Wade Widmer getting some time in on that defensive line, along with sophomore Romeo Galasso. In that defensive backfield, you'll see Sean Walker, who had a tremendous game the last few weeks, as well as Justin Goring, who has established himself as the lead running back, force to be reckoned with over at corner. And don't forget, you got Chris Brown, as well as several other Mustangs that will definitely make an impact on the defensive side of the ball.
Of course, we see Mustangs captains at midfield, including in that bunch, two of those players you just mentioned, Kellenbach, number 86, and Big Jonah Tavai, number 41, right in the middle. Also joined as the captain rounds there by number 71, Wade Romer, the big left tackle for the Mustangs offensive line, as well as Samuel Blake, the Mustangs center. That kind of leads me really right to our next quick topic of conversation. That Mustangs O-line has been outstanding this season, not only opening up holes for Justin Goring in the run game, but giving quarterback, sophomore quarterback Reed Vabre, plenty of time in the pocket. Jeremy, talk to me just real quick about what's impressed Mustangs offense.
Well, you said it all there, Chris, is the in the passing attack, they have given Reed Vabre, the sophomore quarterback, all the time he has needed to find open receivers. And in that running attack, they have blasted open some holes for Justin Goring all season long. You know, center, you got Sam Blake busting and leading that Mustang line right up the middle. You have Ryan Ohomezian, you got James Rawls, Tyler Gary, you have Wade Widmer, and this line is really coming together. Hopefully, Ryan Ohomezian will get back into the lineup soon. He's been out with an infection. Hopefully, he'll be back. I'm looking forward to seeing him back here at Waller Stadium. But the Mustangs definitely have been quite a force on that offensive line. And replacing Ryan, we have Robert Bean in replacing the All-Bay League guard Ryan Ohomezian.
And this game is underway. Mustangs kick off. Morningside receives number one, Patrick Jeannot, with the return, gets out to the 20-yard line, where he's stopped by the Mustangs. The Mustangs, of course, in their home green uniforms, Morningside in the road, white and red.
Yeah, like I mentioned before, Patrick June is definitely one of those players that we want to keep an eye out on. Again, number 17, the quarterback for Morningside, is another one. Aaron Turner is another one to keep an eye out. And then you got Tyron Harvey, number 4. Those are their main players so far, so it'll be interesting to see how Rayleigh's defense will contain them.
Morningside starts the game off with a motion penalty, moving 5 yards back. Now, great double coverage here by the Mustang secondary forces the incompletion, so it's going to bring up a quick second and 15. Turner on the handoff of the Mustangs are right there. Jonah Tavai with the tackle.
Yeah, that was going to be tough to run on this Mustang interior line with Jonah Tavai and Galasso up the middle.
Third and long here for the Monarchs. Scrolling, rolling, and finally throwing back in the middle of the field and almost intercepted. was quarterback Aaron Turner. Boy, he got lucky on that one. Sort of threw it up for grabs, but right into the heart of the Mustangs' D. Call is incomplete, so it is fourth down and punting for the Monarchs.
Yeah, Chris, it, with this being, the middle of Bay League action, we're going to keep a close eye over at the Redondo Palos Verdes game being played at Redondo. That in this Costa team should determine the top three spots in this league, in the Bay League action. So we'll keep a close eye as the night goes on.
Meantime, it's a high but very short kick by Morningside. Takes a little bit of a friendly roll, but that one is down at the 35-yard line. So the Mustangs will take over with good field position. There is a flag on the field. So let's see what this call is here. And it's against Morningside. That penalty is declined. The Mustangs take over. First and 10 at the 34-yard line. The break quickly incomplete. Trying to hit his receiver on the quick slant there. So it's second and 10 coming up for the Mustangs. Mustangs' first offensive possession contest. The Brady shotgun. Morningside, oh boy, they looked to me like they may have been offside. Let's see if that is indeed the call here. Officials are discussing this. Morningside very quickly in the Mustangs' backfield. And it is because they were offside, so it's a repeat second down with the 3 5 yards, second and 5 coming up.
We got a chance to see number 75, Ryan Ohanesian, on the sideline and helping out Matt Baker. And there's a nice completion to Sean Walker over the middle.
And that will be enough for a Mustangs first down, first big play for this Mustangs offense tonight, getting lower down to the 18. Mustangs now on the ground, pounding forward and closer towards that goal line. There was the Mustangs. Looked like that was maybe number three, Justin Goring. The Mustangs started the season off with a running back by committee, but it's been Goring's job almost exclusively. That time, LeBray just misses Goring coming out of the backfield. Incomplete.
Down. 5 yards to go.
Three down for the Mustangs. And it's a handoff. Goring trying to break free, gets down to the 5. Very nearly broke that one for the first touchdown of the night for either team. Either way, though, it is first and goal Mustangs coming up.
Yeah, first down for that must. Another key first down.
And that ball's loose. It pops out, and the Monarchs recover. I don't think quarterback Reed Dupree ever even got that one. Little misty there. Center quarterback exchange. Turnover Mustangs. Meantime, Andrew Tate with the carry brought down nicely by the Mustangs secondary. Second down coming up.
Yeah, Chris, let's see if this Mustangs can recover from that early turnover deep in Monarch territory.
Mustangs showing blitz, but looks like the Monarchs able to coax the Mustangs offside here. Encroachment defense. That is indeed the call. Shotgun. Turner, he's looking left, now he's scrambling right, under pressure, turns to the corner, only gets about 2 yards on the play there. Good job by Mustang secondary to step up. Turner. Ripple under pressure again. Rolls right through. Deep right, but throws out of bounds. Incomplete. The Mustangs defense stepping up here.
Yeah, Chris, a lot of offenses have tried to throw on number 25, Sean Walker, because of his size, but what they don't know is that he is a heck of a leaper and well times his leap and is very tough to complete passes against.
Andrew Tate only gets a couple of yards on that play, so it's third down coming up for the Monarchs. Third and long, Mustang throwing blitz again. They bring the pressure. Turner under pressure and slides down right after the 20-yard line. So well short of her fourth down and punting. About to come up here.
Yeah, Chris, looks like the Mustangs defense did recover from that fumble from the Mustang offense and will get the ball back with good field position.
So Monarchs set the punt. We are here in the opening quarter. Morningside, the low team. Oh, that ball, bad snap over the head of quarterback Turner. Scrambles just to get it out of the end zone. Ends up completing that one to Brian Watts. Heads up play there by Turner, though it will still be a Mustangs ball over on downs.
Yeah, Chris, you mentioned it. That was a crazy play. It was. Monarchs were in punt formation. The ball was snapped over the punter's head. Punter actually did get the kickoff. It was deflected and then deflected a second time by a Mustang defensive player. However, because of the original block, it will go to the Mustangs where Morningside touched it the second time. So, I mean, officials are still discussing exactly the location of the ball. It's going to be Mustang ball, but what a crazy play there to change possession.
So the Mustangs will take over here, first and 10. Ball spotted at the 5-yard line. Mustangs tackled up. Morningside saying they have the ball. Mustangs saying they have the ball. Let's see what the officials say.
Ball is loose once again.
Yeah, it appeared that Justin Goring might have dropped the ball there briefly, but then recovered his own fumble.
So the Mustangs here now on second down. The Bray in shotgun. Looks left, throws left, and that is, tipped and almost intercepted, but will go down as an incomplete pass. So it's third down coming up. Looks like Morningside jumped at the ball, but not able to come up with the pick.
Yeah, big third down play for the Mustangs here.
The Bray rolling right. He scrambles, he keeps it, lunges forward, gets down to the tee, and is stopped short of the goal line. So it'll be fourth and goal coming up here for the Mustangs. We're going to spot this one at the 4. Mustangs special teams coming out.
Number 5, Zach Saros, will attempt the 20-yard field goal.
There's a snap, the kick is up, it's high, it's free, and it is good! So the Mustangs get on the scoreboard first with a 3-0 lead here in the opening quarter.
Chris, I'd like to take this time to check some scores from around the Bay League. over at Redondo. It's scoreless between the Seahawks and the Sea Kings in the first quarter. And over in Inglewood, it is scoreless between the Panthers and the Sentinels over in other Bay League action. Patrick June with a nice return for the Monarchs will bring the 18 to 19 yard line for Morningside to start this drive with under 6 minutes to go in the first quarter. Ball is on the ground and recovered by Morningside and tackled in the backfield by Jonah Tavai.
Yeah, Morningside has definitely been having issues with that snap. Of course, they had that punt issue earlier. Bad snap well over the head of the punter. That time they were able to cover, but oh, what a nice tackle out there on the corner by the Mustangs D. That was number 25, Walker.
Yeah, Chris, like I mentioned, Sean Walker's had a big season so far with a couple of key plays in the last few games.
Aaron Turner looking left, throws left, and throws wide left. Incomplete. Good coverage by the Mustangs. Forces a fourth down situation for Morningside. Morningside has yet to get anything going on offense. Sean Walker back to receive. It's a high snap, short kick. Mustangs have a chance to get good field position again as this one bounces out of bounds at about the 43-yard line. So the Mustangs take over first. Shotgun formation, Vabre, play action. And he did hand off to that first back through. Mustangs get about 8 yards on an opening carry by Mustangs number three, Justin Goring. Second and short for the Mustangs. And it's a QB keeper. Looks like a option there by the Mustangs. But quarterback Vabrea tucked that ball in and decided to just pull it right back out. Tempted himself, got good yardage, third and short.
Actually, Chris, we got a new quarterback in for the Mustangs. Number six, Jordan Lacey, is in for the Mustangs. I'm not exactly sure why quarterback for Bray is out on this drive. Let's see what happens as the game goes on, as Mustangs are in punt formation.
There's the snap. And flag is thrown, so let's see what the penalty is. It's against the Mustangs.
Mustangs have started off a little bit sloppy so far on the offense and special teams with penalties and a turnover. And a near turnover on that on this drive. So let's see what Coach Morrow can do to get this team back online.
Snap to the right of Tavai. Good kick. Takes a high bounce through the end zone. So that will be a touchback for Morningside. First and 10 coming up at the 20. Mustangs lead this contest 3-0 here in the opening quarter.
Yeah, like I mentioned, the offense is a little bit stagnant, but that defense has come to play as another nice tackle, that time by Cody Kellenbach, as, among others, in on that play.
So second down and 10 coming up. That one stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Quarterback Turner hands this one off. Andrew Tate with a nice run right up the middle. Finally stopped by the Mustangs number six, Jordan Lee. Again, just mentioned Jordan in that quarterback as well. So two straight plays here offensively and defensively for Lacey. But meantime, Morningside on the first down throw downfield. It's up, it's tipped up, and intercepted, and that pitch back. Mustangs tipped that ball by Walker. Delgarian comes up with the pick, and then pitches to Cole Trejo for a huge play. First down, Mustangs. It's a play by Delgarian to pitch that. We've got a turn on the play.
Yeah, Chris, let's take another look at this play. Again, great job by that Mustang defensive backfield to work together to get this play done. As we see, number 25, Sean Walker, has a height disadvantage, leaps up, deflects the ball up to Harrison Delgarian, and as Harrison's getting tackled, he pitches it back to Cole Trejo, who gets it all the way to the Morningside 30-yard line. Again, great job by that Mustang defensive backfield.
So the Mustangs take over, first and 10, leading 3-0. He's still in that quarterback, takes the snap, scrambles, looking to throw on the run, instead throws it away. Smart play by Lacey. Second down and 10 coming up. Shotgun for Lacey, hands off. Good run by the Mustangs. Number 3, Gorey. Let's see, there is a flag. Let's see what that call is. And it's motion against the Mustangs.
Yes, this Mustang offense has not looked sharp so far, with a lot of penalties so far in this beginning of this game.
He rolls right, throws deep, and oh, incomplete. Did have a man open, but not able to connect with number 9, Alec Ushida, who's really stepped up his game in recent weeks. But it's fourth down for the Mustangs. They will go for it. And looks like the Mustangs may have tripped the Monarchs outside. Indeed, that is the call. Fourth down still, but now fourth and 4. AC in shotgun. AC hands off. That was the Mustangs number 21, Evison Franklin, to carry. Stopped just shy of the first down marker, so that will be a turnover on downs. Monarchs take over, first and 10. Monarchs with a little switch up at quarterback. Tyron Harvey comes in almost like a wildcat formation, but that play is stopped, and that is how this first quarter will end, with the Mustangs leading 3-0.
Yeah, Chris, I like to take this time to remind the fans that you can keep up with up-to-date, up-to-the-minute information on the Mustang football team by logging on to Facebook, Keyword Ball Players, and on Twitter, at Coast of Football and at Jeremy Sadowski. And remember, all of our football videos are available online on YouTube on the Maricosta Football channel. And I got a couple score updates. In Inglewood, it's 0-0 between Peninsula and Inglewood, and it's 0-0 between Palos Verdes and Redondo at Redondo.
Good time, nice run here by Tyron Harvey. Jeremy, you mentioned that this young man in the pregame or the pregame ceremony series, we talked about this Monarch team. He showed his freaking and elusiveness there. Huge game. Let's see, this may be coming back based on the official's reaction, but wow, what a nice run there by Tyron Harper.
Yeah, Chris, he does definitely have that breakaway speed as we saw there, but it might have been a bad block that is going to bring this one back. Let's see what officials are talking it over with the Morningside coaching staff.
Still, we can get the official word by the reaction. Perhaps it is against the Mustangs, but a little bit further downfield. And now, because everyone is moving downfield, let's see what the official call is here. And it is first down, Monarchs. So that play will stand as a huge run here. It goes right back to the ground game for Morningside. Andrew Tate with the carry. Second and long eight for Morningside. Harvey still in at quarterback. But Mustangs do a good job and on first and second down, so it's third and long coming up for the Monarchs.
Lappert with a nice tackle on that last play.
Best field position of the night for sure. And that ball is loose. Bad snap. Mustangs right there. Boy, that snap center quarterback exchange issue continues to be a big problem for the Monarchs.
Yeah, Chris, that has been their biggest issue so far tonight, is the bad snapping by the center.
So now on fourth down, Morningside, after what was a promising drive for the Monarchs, forced to punt. Mustangs take over, and on the first down play, it's a run right up the middle. Warren with a big run.
Yeah, Chris, and quarterback Reed Vabre is back in for the Mustangs at quarterback. First
and
10,
Mustangs. And this play is stopped. Let's see what the officials call, and it's against the Monarchs. Bray with the handoff. Mustangs run right up the middle. Again, it was Goring with the carry, so short yardage coming up for the Mustangs. Bray with the handoff. Goring makes a couple of cuts, gets all the way down to the 40-yard line. First and 10, Mustangs. Now that offense is starting.
Yeah, Chris, that Mustang appears that there was a penalty, and that will be from the spot of the foul, so it'll bring up second down and one.
About 1 yard to go.
And
Mustangs looks like they may have gotten enough for the first.
Justin Goring and Goring. Huge pickup on the play again, Goring.
Indeed they did. First and 10 Mustangs.
And timeout here, Morningside.
Definitely not the smoothest offensive performance thus far tonight for the Mustangs, no doubt about it, but they are showing signs of life, Goring especially. Looks like he's starting to find his groove. If he does, that could be big trouble for the Monarchs.
Yeah, Chris, as you called it, once Justin Goring gets into that groove and starts reading those blocks, he is tough to stop.
Speaking of, Goring made a nice run there on the left side. Good lead block on the play by the Mustangs. number 56. Of course, that is Samuel Blake pulling. Short yardage, Mustangs. The Bray hands off and going, pounds his way forward, using that sprint there. Looks like he'll be close to a first round, maybe a hair shy. Indeed, he is third and inches for the Mustangs.
Yeah, another big third down play for the Mustang offense.
This time, Mustangs' O-line opens up two huge holes. Goring takes it outside for the first down, but even if Fabre had decided to keep that one, he would have had a big hole up the middle, too. Good job, O-line. First and 10, Mustangs. Shotgun Fabre. And in motion. Takes the snap. And oh! And last second, tried to pull that one back there on the read option, but the ball was knocked loose. And Fabre did recover, but a loss on the play. Mustangs on the ground. Goring sees corner in the end zone and sees a touchdown for the Mustangs. Justin Goring in for the score.
Yeah, Chris, and he definitely went and got to Chris Brown, who he appreciated a nice block there, springing him for that touchdown.
As we take a look at this one again, Jeremy talking to me about that blocking on that O-line.
Yeah, Chris. Justin touched into the end zone. The Mustang line just paved the way, and then Chris Brown finished off the last defender, and Goring got in for the touchdown, untouched.
So the Mustangs finally on the scoreboard from a touchdown perspective. Of course, they led prior to that play 3-0 thanks to the field goal by Soros. Now the point after attempt is up high, straight and good. So the Mustangs lead 10-0 here in the second quarter.
And I got an update over at Redondo. It's Palos Verde 7, Redondo nothing. And over in Inglewood, it's still scoreless between Peninsula and Inglewood.
New timeout. Well, that kick goes out of bounds, so Monarchs will get some good field position here. Kind of dangerous situation for the Mustangs defense. The Mustangs lead 10-0. Morningside has shown some big playability, of course, on that last drive. Harvey was able to get a huge run all the way down to the 30. Fortunately for the Mustangs, a couple of penalties and a bad snap took them out of scoring range, but Mustangs cannot relax here on defense. Good special teams play there by the Mustangs, number 27. That's Kevin Russell. And Ty Harvey on the rollout keeps it himself, and just got done talking about Harvey's playmaking ability. He shows it again there. Gets all the way down to the 40-yard line, first and 10, Monarchs.
Yeah, Chris, Harvey is definitely a player that the Mustangs need to keep a close eye on as he is back in that Wildcat formation.
Harvey throws this time, completes the Tate, and brought down quickly after only a one-yard gain by the Mustangs defense. Frank Love involved in that tackle.
Speaking of Frank Love, I saw Evanson's brother Sebastian Frank Love here at the game, here rooting on his brother Evanson. Sebastian's over at El Camino. It's good to see one of the former Mustangs greats back here at Waller.
Meantime, Harvey under pressure, and then he goes sack for the Mustangs D.
Yeah, Yeah, that was Brogan Tyre on the play. He stepped up and he made a nice sack for the Mustang defense.
So now, Centennial throws in incomplete back-to-back drives by the Monarchs that set it off very promising, but the Mustang D comes up big.
The Mustang D has come up big all night long, as we have seen the bend and don't break philosophy by Coach Ray Lee, as we see Sean Walker on the return getting a nice return past the 30 to about the 34 yard line.
Walker, a very dangerous return man. And this time a penalty here. It's against the Monarchs, so the Mustangs will get some extra yardage. Mustangs lead 10-0 here in the second quarter as the officials mark off that personal foul penalty. 49 yard line, first and. Just about set, ready to go here. First and 10. The Brave throwing it over the top and just incomplete. Intended for JC Bonner, second and 10 coming up. Bray and shotgun. Hands off. Big play there. Goring still going. Wow. Broke and tackled right on the sideline. Impressive run by Goring. First and 10. Mustangs.
Yeah, you called it. Justin Goring changed gears, slowed down, right, broke a tackle, then turned it up and got an additional 5 to 10 yards.
Now Mustangs on the air and oh my goodness, that was inches away from a touchdown. Fabre going for Casey Bonner, but Casey not able to come up with the catch. Fabre now on the handoff. Going, using that niftiness there, showing some shifty moves. Gets all the way down to the 24-yard line. What a run by Gorin.
Yeah, Chris. It looked like he was going to be stopped for a loss, but he was able to weave his way through the Monarch defense for a good game.
We do have a penalty here.
Penalty on the play.
And it is holding against the Mustangs. Lots of penalties in this X, which has been very unlike the Mustangs squad so far this season. Meantime, Burbray looking middle, throws in incomplete. Intended there for number 25, Walker. Of course, Walker, I'm sorry, it may have been Chris Brown, the intended target. Either way, both players explosive and dynamic. So. Could have been a big play. Instead, it's third. Fabre rolling right. Under pressure. Stops, plants, throws. And that one, looks like that may be intercepted. And it is. Turnover Mustangs. Monarchs take over. First and.
Yeah, that was number one, Patrick June, with a nice interception for the Monarchs.
Time Turner back in at quarterback throws, and that's incomplete. Good coverage by the Mustang secondary. Second and 10 coming up.
My apologies, no 25 here on the roster.
As we can see some of the vehicles in the background, again, fans, this is homecoming night, so stay tuned for a special halftime presentation. Meantime, Monarchs, Harvey back in at quarterback. Incomplete, intended for June.
Third down, 10 yards.
Third
field,
down coming up. Under pressure. Now it is back to Turner. He goes down. Sacked by the Mustangs. Still carrying.
Sack in the backfield.
Blasso also involved.
Yeah, great job by the Mustangs defense to corral quarterback Turner and bring him down for the loss. As there's flag on the play, we have the referee coming over to talk to Coach Morrow. Not sure exactly what the call is on this one, Chris.
I have to see you. Meantime, as much as this Mustangs offense has had some inconsistencies tonight, this Mustangs defense has been spot on. Bad punt as the Mustangs had plenty of pressure on the Monarchs kicker. So the Mustangs will take over with amazing field position. Mustangs go to the ground. Has a chance. Has end zone. Going. Touchdown. Mustangs.
I think there was a penalty in on this play. Another penalty. Yet another penalty. This Mustang offense has definitely not looked like itself so far this game, as they have just been racking up the penalties early. Call against the Mustangs will bring up a first down and long for the Mustangs.
Too bad, too, because that was a nifty move there by Goring. Found the corner of the end zone. Would have had a touchdown. Meantime, Mustangs back to the air, and that's intercepted.
Ball is picked off.
Monarchs return this one all the way. Touchdown, pick six. Monarchs picking off Jordan Lacy.
The pick six for Morningside. It's a new ball game as we approach.
Yeah, Chris, let's take another look at this play. It appeared that the ball was intended for the Mustang receiver and went off his hands as Chris Brown was making a play, and it just happened when it went off of Chris Brown's hands right into the hands of Aaron Turner, who had no one in front of him, and the Monarchs are on the board.
Jeremy, you mentioned it, the Monarchs, though, overall lacking team depth, they do have a couple of skilled position players, one of which is Harvey, who we mentioned, and then, of course, Aaron Turner, the quarterback for the Monarchs, also a defensive stalwart. Meantime, another bad snap, and the Mustangs are there for the big hit. This time it's Franklin.
I know Evanson's brother Sebastian would be proud of that play by his younger brother Evanson on the Mustang special team.
Justin Goring, Sean Walker back to receive a kick.
So the Monarchs now set to kick.
Over in Inglewood, it is still scoreless between the Sentinels and the Panthers. And over at Redondo, it is 7-0 Palos Verdes as Morningside recovers the onside kick.
Onside kick by Morningside. Looks like it's recovered by the Monarchs.
Monarchs going for broke here. Trying to capture any momentum they can to catch the Mustangs off guard. So it's a handoff right up the middle. The Mustangs beat that one perfectly. Kavai involved in that hit.
Lost the final of the play, calling second.
shot. There's, ooh, bad snap. Luckily able to keep it and just tossing it to the side is the Monarchs quarterback Turner, as he had Tavai and Galasso right on top.
You know what, Chris? If I was the Monarchs coach, I would consider bringing Turner under center with all of these issues with the snapping so far this game.
It certainly can't get any worse, that's for sure here for Monarchs. Meantime, Mustangs again with pressure. Harvey on the scramble though. Still going, finally knocked out of bounds just shy of the 30. Broken play from the Monarchs, and Harvey turns it into a big game with 22 seconds left in this first half.
Yeah, the Monarchs took my advice and brought Harvey up under center, but now he's back in shotgun.
So here comes Harvey under pressure again, forced to scramble. You almost wonder for the Mustangs that would be better off letting them sit back in that pocket. Two plays in a row now, the Mustangs D-line has gotten immediate pressure on Harvey, but he's been able to scramble out of trouble that time, though. There is holding against the Monarchs. Harvey in shotgun, under pressure again, and this time the Mustangs are able to bring him down. That was Galasso, the sophomore sensation.
Yeah, Chris, you called it, and that will end the first half with the Mustangs up 10-6. Stay tuned, fans, for a very special homecoming halftime edition of Mustang Football. Welcome back, fans, to a special halftime edition of Mustang Football as the new homecoming king and queen are crowned and the Mustangs are getting ready for the third quarter of action.
Mustangs start this second half leading 10-6. It's been maybe one of the most inconsistent offensive first half for the Mustangs. But for them, a typically dominating defensive effort has kept this one really at a 10-6 score. That lone touchdown by the Monarchs was thanks to a tip pass interception, pick six. Otherwise, this defense has kept the Monarchs out of the end zone.
Yeah, Chris, and again, our other Bay League action that we have going on, a big Bay League contest over at Redondo between Palos Verdes and Redondo Seahawks. has the Sea Kings up 7-0 at halftime. And then over at halftime at Inglewood, it's Palos Verde, or it's Palos Verde's Peninsula 0, Inglewood 0. So it's a lot of tightly fought Bay League games tonight here at Waller Stadium. It's a tight one here instead of Bay League so far this evening.
So the Mustangs' lone touchdown was a touchdown run by Goring. Speaking of Goring, he's got himself a kick return going. He's got daylight in front of him. Not a single Monarch in sight. Touchdown Goring on the kick return. What a way for the Mustangs to open up this second half.
Yeah, Chris, the Mustang special teams have really come through tonight for Maricosta as Zach Zeros had the 20-yard field goal to start off the scoring. And then we've just seen Justin Goring with a scoring return of his own as he takes that ball, it looks like, at about the 7-yard line at this play. And he goes untouched.
Impressive run by return by Goring. Good blockers in front of him. And once he gets that daylight, it is nothing but speed. Goring has such an impressive combination of shifting moves, smarts using the blockers in front of him, and then that speed. He's got a second line, gets out in the open field. He can really crank up that full sprint to an entirely different level that these defensive backs for the Monarchs just can't keep up with.
Yeah, Chris, and so far no one this season has really been able to keep up with Justin Goring once he gets into that open field.
Goring initially started off this season as a receiver, but with the Mustangs going with almost more of a running back by committee, but he was just so talented. The coaching staff knew they had to get the ball in his hands way more often than they were, and that was when they made that move to running back. And boy, what a brilliant move by head coach Don Moore. Meantime, Patrick June with a nice return for the Monarchs, and a little bit of scrambling here. A flag is thrown right at that Monarch sideline.
Appears to be a personal foul against the Monarchs, so that will knock him back from that really good field position to start the ball in their first drive here in the second half.
So let's see if the Mustangs defense can continue that impressive effort we saw in that first half. And they start off with a great start right there. That ball is loose. Mustangs say they recovered.
Yeah, Chris. There was a fumbled exchange between the quarterback and the running back, and Cody Kellenbach saw it all the way and jumped on the ball, recovering it for the Mustangs.
Mustangs take over first and 10, and they go straight to the air. Incomplete, and the flag comes in. But we do have a flag back at the line of scrimmage as well. Let's sort this all out here. We got a hold against the Mustangs and a hold against the Monarchs. Those penalties were offset. Mustangs. And oh, what a big run. Judah Tavai, the bully ball, is ready down to the seven.
Judah Tavai
first and 10 Mustangs.
Yeah, Chris, we haven't seen much of Jonah Tavai running tonight, but he just ran right through the Monarchs' defense on that play.
Affirmation for the Mustangs by Bray. And in motion. And off goes to Gorin, right up the middle, off right guard and into the end zone. Touchdown, Mustangs. Justin Gorin in for his third touchdown of the evening.
Yeah, Chris, that was a nice hole made by the Mustangs up the middle, led by number 56 up the middle.
The time to point after attempt is up, it's high, it's straight, and it is good. That will make this contest now 24-6. Mustangs with the lead.
Yeah, Mustangs have started off this second half very impressively, scoring two times within a minute and 11 seconds.
In time, June with the return, but stopped quickly out there. Mustangs, number 89, Eddie Bergadonovan, involved in that tackle. Monarchs open up with Harvey in at quarterback, under center. And they shift to a backfield, but that is a penalty against the Monarchs, so it's first and 15. Harvey with the Monarch shifting to an I formation. Handoff right up the middle. Goes nowhere. Monarchs end up getting a little bit of a push, but finally Mustangs come up with the stop. Galasso right involved in that one. Second and 12. And this time, Monarchs tried to turn that edge, but nothing doing. Mustangs defense again comes up big. Clapper may have been involved in that one. Third of the Monarchs. Third and long. Harvey under pressure. Tries to dump it off, and it's incomplete. Mustangs had two men in the backfield with Harvey in their grasp. Incomplete, fourth down and 20. Here's the snap. It's a high kick. It's a short kick. Walker, very dangerous return man as well. Has D-Lake, gets a couple of key blocks, breaks a tackle, and gets into the end zone. Touchdown Mustangs, special teams again comes up with a big play.
Yeah, Chris, a great return by Walker. I did see a flag on the field. Let's see what happens here. Looks like the referee is going to wave that flag off. It is a touchdown. Another tremendous play by the Mustangs special teams, able to return that punt the distance for the touchdown. And let's take another look at this play, as the punt is initially dropped by Walker, and then he recovers it and then just turns on the speed, gets a great block there, and then another block, and then it's just Walker's speed which enables him to get into the end zone untouched, just like Justin Goring was on the kickoff return, untouched for the Mustang touchdown.
Saras getting to work out here in the third quarter on to attempt the
Mustang setting up for the extra point. The kick is up, the kick is high, the kick is free, and that kick is good. Mustangs now lead this contest 31-6.
Yeah, Chris, again, the special teams with another big, big play with a punt return for a touchdown by Sean Walker. You've had the kickoff return for a touchdown by Justin Groen and the field goal by Zach Saros.
Exactly on a night when the Mustangs offense was the special teams and take them.
Again, I got a score update from Redondo. Palos Verdes is now up 14-0 in the third quarter versus the Sea Kings. Over in Inglewood, Peninsula is up 8-0 over the Sentinels.
Time first and 10 coming up here for the Monarchs. Harvey at quarterback rolling right. Under pressure, stops. Feet back down and is finally knocked out at the 50-yard line. So second down coming up here for the Monarchs. Second and about three. Two tape behind Tyon Harvey. Harvey under pressure scrambles and he is hit. The ball pops loose to buy it and force the fumble, but the Monarchs luckily able to come back up with the ball there. But another big play by the Mustangs, D.
Yeah, Chris, that was an interesting play there. It appeared that Tavai knocked the ball loose, and then it appeared to hit Galasso's helmet, popping it straight up for a Monarch offensive lineman who caught it in midair and then was knocked down behind the line of scrimmage.
So the Mustangs defense again continues to impress here against the Monarchs. So far tonight, the only touchdown by the Monarchs was on a pick six and intercepted in turn for a touchdown. Mustang's defense has not given up a single point to this Monarch zone. In time that punt takes a Monarch's roll, bounces out of bounds. Let's see where they spot this, but the Mustangs will take over. First and 10 with 7:31 left to go here in this third quarter, and the Mustangs leading 31-6. Mustangs start off on the ground and finally brought down just shy of the 10-yard line is the Mustangs, Justin Groen, of course, scoring three touchdowns tonight. One on the kickoff return, two rushing touchdowns. Of course, the Mustangs' other touchdown by Walker on a punt return. So Groen having a three touchdown performance here.
Groen went out that previous play with what appeared to be a little shaken up, and he's back in on this play.
So let's see what the Mustangs do here on fourth and punting. See if the Mustangs can get a big booming punt. Of course, the Mustangs would have liked to have taken a little bit more time off the clock on that possession, but let's see if the defense can again continue to hold strong. A good punt down at the 45-yard line by the Mustangs. So the Monarchs will take over first and 10 here. Penalty against Morningside, so that has moved them back. First and 10, ball spotted at the 30-yard line now. shot. Good. Bad snap again. Turner does a good job just to keep this one in his possession. Shuffle passes out of bounds to take the incomplete versus taking a huge loss, but a flag does come in, and it's intentional grounding against Turner. Officials conferring on this one, but that was the initial call here.
Yeah, the Monarchs have struggled all night with the snapping. Any kind of long snapping from punts to shotguns have been an issue all night for these Monarchs, and they are battling through this, and it's definitely been an issue, and Turner was just lucky enough to get rid of that ball out of get it out of his hands after that bad snap.
It seems like almost every play, Mustang's D-line is in the quarterback's face. And again, as we see right there, Mustang's come up with another tackle for a loss. It's third and long. Bad snap goes over the head of quarterback Turner to the back of the end zone. That's a safety for the Mustangs D. Jeremy, you just got done talking about those snappy issues for the Monarchs, and boy, does that burn them there. Safety Mustangs.
Yeah, Chris, again, if I was the Monarchs coaching staff, I would consider having quarterback go under center every play just to avoid all of these bad snapping issues. But then again, like we've seen, they can't avoid these issues with the snapper, which it's definitely a shame to see a team at this level with these type of issues.
Meantime, Mustangs again with another nice return. Mustangs lead 31-6 with good field position thanks to another great play by the Mustangs special teams, and now they pound the ball forward for a big gain on first down. Quarterback keeper by quarterback Reed Bray. 9 yards, second and one. Shotgun for Bray. Hands off. Warren makes a couple moves, fights his way forward, knocked out of bounds, but boy, he was getting really close to that end zone.
Goring having a heck of a night. Adjusting as well.
First and goal, Mustang.
The coast to O-line.
And this one is being blown dead. It was going to be a read option by quarterback Reed Bray, but instead it's motion against the Mustangs. So now it's first and goal, but from the 13-yard line. Bray hands off to Goring. He's got a little bit of a crease. He's still fighting forward, gets all the way down to the 1 yard line. Following his lead blockers, Goring does a great job by his inny back in the Bay League for following his blockers, and then once he sees that daylight, he's got the speed to get there. Ball goes to Goring again, fighting forward, trying to twist, but never quite able to get started there. Good play by Baker. Third down coming up. Bray hands off. Mustangs really want to get Goring in, and he does. He says, thank you, coaches. I will happily take my third handoff on this drive. Touchdown, Mustangs. Justin Goring's fourth touchdown of this contest. Mustangs offense is rolling.
Yeah, it took some time for the Mustang offense to get rolling, Chris, but like you said, it is rolling now here in this third quarter of action, and the Mustangs are rolling on special teams, defense, and offense, and this team is starting to look like a contender for the Bay League title.
The rough first half for the Mustangs, second half, starting with the first play of the second half, that big hit return for touchdown. It's been nothing but Mustang, and good news for the Mustangs all straight through this third quarter. Impressive offensive explosion. This was a 10-6 game at the half.
Yeah, Chris, I got a couple early fourth quarter scores over at Redondo. The Seahawks are trailing 21-0 versus Palos Verdes over in Inglewood. Next week, opponent is Inglewood for the Mustangs, and the Palos Verdes Peninsula Panthers are up 8-6.
And that's a little bit of a pooch kick taken by one of the outmen for the Monarchs. That was Sammy Boyard with the return, but the Mustangs defense right there brings them down immediately. So with the Mustangs leading 40-6, the Monarchs are back out on offense. It is a rollout for Turner, who throws deep, has good coverage down there. Mustangs ended up with double coverage thanks to a good read by Kevin Russell, but good coverage, kind of a 50-50 ball there for Turner. Goes incomplete, so it's 2nd and 10. Motion by Ryan Smith, giving three receivers to the right of Turner. He's pressured that direction. Throws it up for grabs and incomplete. Mustangs defense again had pressure right in the face of quarterback Turner. Third down and 10. Four receivers set. Three receivers to the right of quarterback Turner. Stops, fakes, rolls left, keeps it, and is knocked out of bounds. Big hit. Turner's thighs are going to be feeling that one tomorrow. What a monster hit by the Mustangs.
Yeah, Chris, you called it. That was a hard hit by the Mustangs on quarterback Aaron Turner. As now we have Harvey back in at quarterback for the Monarchs.
Fourth down play for the Monarchs. Harvey under pressure. Escapes that pressure and somehow fights forward for a first down. Oh boy, Mustangs had a couple of chances to knock him down before that first down marker, but Harvey's speed and elusiveness able to get the Monarchs a first down and keep them alive. Harvey and shotgun. Scrambles under pressure again, somehow escapes that pressure. Still on his feet, makes a nifty run at the 30-yard line. Boy, Harvey showing his athletic ability as the Mustangs had him in their grasp, but that is how that quarter ends.
Remind fans to keep up to the minute information on the Mustangs team by logging on to Facebook, keyword MaraCosta High School Football Players, on Twitter at Costa Football and at Jeremy Sadowski, and the MaraCosta Football Channel on YouTube. And again, I got a late score here at Redondo late in the fourth quarter. It's now 28-0. Palos Verdes over Redondo, and over in Inglewood against next week's opponent for the Mustangs, the Inglewood Sentinels are trailing Peninsula 8-6 late in the fourth quarter. So it'll be interesting to see how this Bay League shapes up, as it looks like Redondo's going to take a loss. Inglewood's going to be, looks to be 1-1, and another bad snap.
Boy, the Monarchs just can't get that quarterback-center exchange going for him. Huge play, Mustangs come up with another tackle there. They called that one a sack. Thanks to the bad snapping here, that's caused Monarchs points on the board, both in the sense of field position and literally in the case of the safety. So, boy, that center quarterback exchange, of course, you got to wonder how much of that is caused by the bowling ball, Jonah Tavai, right in the face of that Monarch center.
Yeah, Chris, it appears on that last play to Patrick June, he appeared to get hit. I'm not sure exactly what the issue is, but he is definitely seriously feeled. I hope he's all right. Now, as you know, this game of football that we love so much is such a violent sport. And again, we hope that Patrick June is going to be okay as his teammates are coming over. And we never like to see this on any kind of football field.
Absolutely, Jeremy. Definitely our thoughts are with Patrick June. We hope that he is okay, the senior receiver, free safety, cornerback for the Monarchs. He's definitely one of their stellar athletes and a very big threat on the field. So we do hope that he is okay. His teammates here rallying around him. Just hoping for the best, taking the helmets off to show them respect and loving up on their teammate.
Yeah, the one good thing is I know I see Tim Cooper and I know there's a lot of doctors here that accompany the Mustangs and there's going to be the best medical care available for Patrick. I thoughts and prayers are definitely with the Monarchs team and Patrick, and hopefully he'll be all right.
Of course, the story of this game up to this point is we now see the medical personnel arriving here on campus, but the big story up to this point here was a sluggish first half for the Mustangs. They went into halftime with only a 10-6 lead and just really sputtering on offense. Luckily, that defense was more than stellar. Kept the Mustangs in this game. And in this second half, particularly third quarter, as we see Patrick being able to make here to the love of his teammates. Hopefully, again, he is okay. But this Mustangs offense has exploded here in this third quarter. Mustangs leading 40-6 here.
Yeah, Chris, we're getting word down from the sidelines that the rest of this game will be called again due to the injury and the score at the time with the Mustangs up 40-6. And again, more importantly than this game on the field is what's going to happen now with Patrick. Again, our thoughts and prayers are with him. I hope for the best. I want to see him back on the football field. I want to see him, you know, resume his football career. And again, all of our thoughts and prayers are with the Morningside football family.
And of course, Jeremy, like you mentioned, this is about so much more than just football. Most of these players here on the field will most likely not continue on their football careers, even past high school. So, for the players, it really is about their futures and about just building that strong character. So, definitely thoughts to Patrick June. We do hope he is okay. Meantime, this is a final. Mustangs do win this time. It's 40-6. Mustangs' win streak now continues with four consecutive wins and now 2-0 in the Bay League, 5-2 overall. So Mustangs do lead this contest with the victory.
Yeah, Chris, and I got a final over at Redondo. Palos Verdes defeated Redondo 35-0. And over in Inglewood, Peninsula defeated Inglewood 8-6.
Of course, Justin Goring, 4 touchdowns. Him and that defense and special teams, the story of tonight. Mustangs win this contest 40-6 as the Mustangs players pray there with certainly with Patrick June and their thoughts as well. So, meantime, Jeremy, let's go down to the field and get player and coach's reaction to this Mustangs victory over the Morningside Monarchs.
Jeremy Sadowski here with Brogan Tire. Brogan, football is family. We might wear different colors out on the field, but we are all one family. Tremendous display of sportsmanship at the end of that game. Getting back to the game, Mustangs had a tremendous game and special teams. Can you talk about tonight's game and the ending there?
Our defense came out strong. We played strong on defense the whole game. Our offense started a little slow for what we wanted, but I think at halftime we really pulled it together. And I think we came together as a team really well in the second half. And I think that kind of played into the ending, how we had it. And unfortunately, a player on their team got injured, but hopefully he's doing well. And I think it was nice that our two teams could kind of come together and bond over that.
This is Jeremy Sadowski here with offense coordinator Matt Baker. Coach Baker, a tough way for a game to end, even though it was with a win. Tremendous display of sportsmanship, however. Can I get your comments on tonight's game?
It was a weird night, definitely, with the first half being unproductive. Homecoming, obviously, is its own thing, and then the second half, you know, somehow we flipped the switch. Special teams started making plays. Defense was making plays. Our offense found a little bit of rhythm. And then, that unfortunate incident at the end there. And all our prayers are with Patrick. So we hope it's just a precautionary thing.